Good evening, sports fans and Beaverheads. Welcome to March.
It's not only Women's History Month and March Madness, it's also an election year. So we're combining all three of our favorite things, voting, sports, and history, to bring you a round robin competition to find who should be the patron saint of Beaver State.
That's right. You've seen it done with sports, and now we're going to be doing it with women. Ranking them against each other.
Just what the sport needed, something fresh, something to really make you examine, what does women's history mean?
What does it mean?
We're gonna find out.
Now we know that there are a lot of incredible women from Oregon, and we've decided to pit them against each other in an ultimate popularity contest to find out who will be the one.
And the lucky winner not only will get the accolade of being the most womanist woman of women's history in Oregon, she will become the patron saint of Beaver State, and we will reference her throughout the show in our first season. So the stakes are high.
They couldn't be higher.
And for total disclosure, none of these women have asked for this. They do not know us. We do not know them.
And they may not be that great.
That's right. We celebrate women's rights and women's realms.
Now, without further ado, we will read off the names of the women competing in this year's WHMM, sponsored by our corporate sponsor, Lady Doritos, the Chicks Chip. Addison, take it away!
Our number one seed is Katherine Jones Harrison. She is a former leader of the Grand Round Tribe and the establisher of Spirit Mountain Casino.
Next we have Esther Pohl Lovejoy. You may know her from the street. But she was also the first woman director of Department of Health in the major city of Portland, Oregon.
Number three, we have Joanne Hardesty. You know her, you love her, the first Black woman commissioner from 2019 to 2022. It took us a long time to get there, Joe, but we're so happy we're there.
We did it, Joe.
Next, we have Jinx Monsoon. She is the winner of season 5 of RuPaul's Drag Race and the winner of season 7 of All Stars, literally an all-star in the building. That's gonna be hard to beat. Next up, we have Chopped champion and owner of Nong's Kamangai, Nong Putsamwintana.
After that, we have Governor Tina Kotek. She was in the House of Reps and now is our Governor of Oregon.
Then up next, we have Beverly Cleary. You know her, you love her, the McMinnville-born author of Ramona and Beezus.
After that, we have got the Shogren sisters. Now this one's a fun one, these are sisters. They were dressmakers and fashionistas.
Next up, we have Toby Wanima Riddle, a negotiator and interpreter for the MODOK tribe.
We have Lisa Renna, who is a housewife of Beverly Hills. She's from Medford, Oregon originally, though. And listen, she's coming off of some allegations. She might be a little bit canceled. But listen, okay, uncancelable women rarely make history.
And speaking of uncancelable, it's Tanya Harding next. The Portland-born figure skater is an iconic figure. Skater.
That's a good one. All right, next up we have Michelle Zahner, the lead singer of the band Japanese Breakfast, author of the book Crying in H Mart. I love that book. Maybe in Oregon.
Then it's Mercedes Days, the first Black woman admitted to the Oregon State Bar.
Next, we have Jenna Schmieding.
Jenna Schmieding!
Who is a Cheyenne River Lakota actress from Camden, Oregon.
You know her and you love her from Rutherford Falls and Reservation Dogs. Then we have Donna Maxey, the founder of Race Talks in Portland. She is a longtime civil rights activist in Oregon, fighting the good fight.
Next we have Ursula K. Le Guin, who is of course an incredible sci-fi author. She was a resident of Portland and just a super cool lady.
Just a great gal. And then we have Mary Lorinda Jane Smith Beatty, the Black abolitionist and suffragist. She was the first Black woman to cast a ballot in 1872.
That's history right there. Next up, we have Dorothy Hester Stencil, who was a pilot and opened up her own flight school in Cornelius, Oregon.
You know those Cornelius fans are really going to be going for her in this matchup. Yes. Arlene Schnitzer comes next. You know her from
Schnitz.
The Schnitz, a great concert hall, great woman, patron to the arts.
Next up, we have Caitlin Olson from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia fame.
Yes, born in Portland, she was raised in Tigard. Next up is Dr. Marie Equi, a lesbian and radical. Love when lesbians are radical.
Level radical lesbian.
A huge proponent of birth control in a time when abortions were illegal. Can't imagine what that was like.
Yeah. Rough time, I bet. Next up, we have Molly Fearless McConnell, who is a boxer, two-time world champion, Oregon Hall of Fame.
You're not going to want to get her in the ring with you, I tell you what. Next, we have Amy Jo Roloff, you know her and love her from TLC's hit Little People, Big World.
Next up, we have Abigail Scott Dunaway, the women's rights advocate and a newspaper editor and writer. She was instrumental in getting women's voting rights.
Next, we have Teresa Rafer, the Portland activist and politician and the founder of Don't Shoot Portland. Mm. Did not become our mayor in the last election cycle, but that doesn't mean she won't in the future. We're grateful for you, Teresa.
Next up, we have Tabitha Moffett Brown, who was the mother of Oregon. I mean,
it's right there in the title. That's gonna be hard to beat.
She was a pioneer from the Oregon Trail.
Then we have Ez Bronza Spalding, the Grammy Best New Artist, way back when, an accomplished jazz musician, a beautiful woman, and all around talent. I think she's attractive. Very
awesome. All right, next up we have Stacy Allison, who was raised in Woodburn, and she was the first U.S. woman to climb Mount Everest.
Next we have Poison Waters from Park Rose High School, a drag queen and icon. You know her, you love her. We love her too.
All right, next up we have Mercedes Betty Crocker Bates.
That's right. Betty Crocker is in the mix.
Betty Crocker is in the mix. She's actually born in Portland. Director of the Betty Crocker Division of the General Mills. Listen, she is Betty Crocker.
You know her from the box at the grocery store.
She's the woman behind the box.
And most of these women are. Next up, we have a personal favorite, Jasmine Savoy Brown, actress from The Leftovers, Yellow Jackets, raised in Springfield, Oregon.
And finally, rounding out this list of incredible women, we have Gert Boyle, who actually fled from Nazi Germany when she was a child, and her father founded Columbia Sportswear. She later was on the chair of the board. Chair of the board. Now that is an incredible list. Wow. Who is going to win? Now that is up to you, the voter. Now each day we are going to be pitting these women against each other.
While highlighting their historical values.
We're going to be learning a lot in the process.
We're going to be learning along the way.
And each winner will be
closer and closer to becoming the patron saint of Beaver's Day.
Yeah, very exciting stuff. Now listen up, you guys need to make your
Make your brackets.
Send them in.
We need to receive your brackets before March 15th when the playoffs start to make sure that you are entered to win the giveaway. The person with the closest bracket will be receiving a giveaway bag full of Beaver State goodies and TBD.
Yeah. Listen, we're gonna throw in some great stuff. It's gonna be an exciting competition. You're gonna wanna enter, you're gonna wanna win.
Speaking of polls, we will be doing the polls in the Instagram stories every day that the playoffs go by. So make sure to have notifications on.
Turn those on. You're not gonna wanna miss it, because what if your fave loses?
Right.
It's gonna be on you.
Right, it's like American Idol. You know, we did not get Jennifer Hudson to the finish line. Look at what happened.
We can't do this again. We can't do it again. Now listen, this is not merit-based. This is purely up to the people. So we need you to turn up.
The fans are going wild.
The fans are screaming for us.
And make sure that you understand that this is satire. Media literacy is important, people.
So important.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Women's History Month, baby.
Women's History Month.
Madness.
Are there any ones that you want to redo?
Surely not.
Probably.